An amazing football career, top athlete in Kentucky, MVP of the National Football League, Pro Bowl, and all the rest of it. He was the first running back in NFL history to record 15 or more touchdowns in 5 consecutive seasons. And also, he looks better in person than he does in his pictures. Shaun Alexander, hey, it's good to have you.
Thank you very much.
Hey, man, you set all those records, and they started beating you up. You broke your foot, and what happened? You broke your wrist?
Yeah, I broke my foot, broke my wrist. It was an amazing time for me because I really felt like right after I won the MVP and the Super Bowl and all that, I started asking God for more. And I felt like he said, are you sure? And those next 2 years were rough because, you know, I broke my foot, broke my wrist, and then no longer was kicked out or fired from playing with the Seahawks. So
they fired you?
Yeah, it was.
What a dirty thing to do.
It's unbelievable.
It's a hard game, isn't it?
It is. So, you know, I came back during that time, and I said, all right, God, what do you want me to do? And I started praying, and God gave me the idea by showing me a dream of these 5 steps, and each step had a name on it. The unbeliever, the believer, the example, the teacher, the imparter. And he said, everybody is on one of these steps, and this is the walk. And that became the book.
Are you an imparter?
I am.
What does an imparter do?
Well, I'll explain all of them. You know, an unbeliever is a person simply who does not believe. I explain in the book that they're a wanderer or a wanderer, just trying to figure it out, or they're just kind of going aimlessly with whatever life's giving them. Okay. A believer is a simple person that just truly believes Jesus did die on the cross and rose again in 3 days. And then the example is the person that can walk out the life. You know, they follow the ways of God the best they can all the time in every area. Right. And then the teacher is not a pastor. I was going to explain to people. A teacher is a person that can explain why they live the life they live. And then you get to the imparter. And the imparter is a person that can really impart God's presence into any situation, whether it's singing, praying, talking. That's what an imparter is.
You know, I was reading your book, and I thought, you know, this guy is a very proficient jock, but he's writing like a theologian. There's some pretty deep stuff in here.
Yeah, I don't know what it was, but God just, he has a plan. And I believe that he gave me football to put me in a place where people could listen, because Jesus, he loves everybody, and his plan is to get everybody to the kingdom.
Did you feel special inspiration? I mean, it was like the Holy Spirit came and revealed some of these things to you?
He did. You know, when I had that dream, I said, all right, God, explain to me what I just saw. And as he broke down everything, he said, Shaun, you know what? This book is going to be for everybody, from the person that's been walking it out faithfully for years, to the kid that's just trying to figure it out, to the grown-up that's like, I don't know if I believe in that Jesus stuff. Mm-hmm. And the book's for everybody, and I'm just honored that God used me to write it.
Well, it's very interesting, some of these things, but I say it's some pretty deep theological concepts for somebody who's a professional athlete.
Right.
So it has to be an anointing of the Holy Spirit.
It definitely has to be, because I tell everybody I've had great mentors in my life that pour into me, and I've been able to mentor some people, but really I don't take what I have as me being anything special or and this deep theologian or this deep thinker. I just love Jesus, and I go after him every day, and I make falls sometimes, and then sometimes I get up, and I luckily make some things look really cool, but really, at the end of the day, Jesus loves, and if you're open, he'll show you some stuff.
Shaun, you said something that you studied the guys who were playing, and you got an edge on them. What did you learn when you were watching films of these opposing players that let you get an extra step in there?
Well, it's amazing because I got to play with some great defensive players like John Randall, who played with the Vikings and came to us in Seattle at the beginning of my career. Uh-huh. And he knew everything about everybody he's playing against. So I started thinking the same thing. Well, what if I knew about their mother, their brothers, their wives?
Really?
What if I knew that this person had a bad day? What if I knew that this is the thing that makes this person play lazily, you know? And I just started breaking down everything. And when I looked up, I was breaking tackles on people because I knew that they weren't going to put their body in that situation to make the play.
Because they were having a bad day with their wife, and they wouldn't tackle as hard, is what you said.
Well, and I'm just meaning from top to bottom, from physically to mentally to emotionally. If you study people, you'll be able to figure out how to be good.
Well, that was incredible. Well, what did that do to you? I mean, MVP, that's a big deal in the pro ranks. I mean, did you feel proud about it, or did you go get on your knees and thank God for your ability?
Well, you know, that MVP season was something amazing in itself. You know, I'm trying to figure out if I was supposed to play with the Seahawks or go to another team. And God really told me, he said, Shaun, humble yourself, come into training camp, even without your contract. Uh-huh. And that's what I did. So that year felt amazing because I felt like, you know, as the people would say, angels were picking me up and throwing me in the end zone a lot that year because
angels were throwing me in the end zone.
Because I really was playing, you know, out of my mind, it felt like the whole time. It was a God thing.
It was. The Holy Spirit was there with you. Do you miss any of that stuff?
You know, I miss the relationships with people. I do miss everybody coming there. Football is the ultimate team sport. Mm-hmm. And you got 11 guys coming together to make one guy score a touchdown, you know, whether it's a pass or a run. It's the ultimate team sport. And, you know, when you have opportunities to do things like that, it makes it not be about you, and that makes it special.
What about... and this is all over with. How do you survive? What do you do to put bread on the table? Or did they do something for you at the Seahawks that took care of you?
Well, you know, football is not like it was in the 80s, you know. You can make a lot of money playing football. Uh-huh. And so that's, you know, so that makes it fun. But really, the whirlwind of playing in the NFL is so fun and amazing, but, you know, you realize when you're done playing, you got to realize that who you are is not what you're doing. Mm-hmm. And I think it's 86% are broken, divorced in the NFL, and I think it's like 65% in the NBA.
Terrible.
You know, so it is because that lifestyle really, you know, it really pushes you to be what, mm-hmm, instead of who.
Were you having trouble, man? You were a devout Christian. Did the guys give you trouble, or did they respect your faith? And was it hard being a Christian in the NFL?
Well, I think that one of the biggest misnomers about people that really love Jesus is that they got to force their faith on other people.
Uh-huh.
And even in the book, I explain to people, you know, the greatest way to get an unbeliever to become a believer, mm-hmm, is not you talk them to death. It's really you to be an example. When you love people, when you're just cracking jokes and you're having fun with people, after a while, they're going to be like, wait, you don't do these things to become satisfied,
yeah,
by the world, but you're still having a fun time.
Mm-hmm.
I want that. That's what an example is. It's, sure, a person that can be with them, love everybody, have a good time, but just not let their self be caught up in the world.
You talked about so many marriages that are broken up. That's a terrible statistic, but yeah. You tell me about your family. You got a wife,
yeah,
children. What do you got?
I met the girl of my dreams my first day in Seattle. Like, everybody laughs at me. They're like, yeah, oh, you first round draft pick, get $1 million contract, and then you meet your wife all in one day. I'm like, you know, God's good.
That's,
you know,
the way it worked.
That's the way it works for me, you know. Yeah. You know, and so we were married 2 years after we met, and then we had three daughters, Heaven. Yeah. Is seven. Trinity
is
five. Eden is three. And we just had a son last year. His name's Joseph Prince. And we are now pregnant with our fifth child right
Grief.
Now. So no one knows that except you and
right,
everybody that's watching now.
Don't let on. Don't anybody,
yeah,
tell.
Yeah. So our family is growing. And the thing you learn about marriage is that your wife has to be your best friend. You, yeah, have to learn how to give her the secrets of your heart because... Yeah. The wife at the end of the day is going to take care of you way more than anybody else, any coach, any friend, any mama, daddy, you,
yeah,
know.
Yeah.
So when you become one with her, you really launch yourself into really being in God's perfect will.
Shaun, you are an inspiration to all of us. It's a joy to have you. And ladies and gentlemen, this is a good book. It's called Shaun Alexander. It's called The Walk. And the things that God showed this man, very extraordinary. And about the various stages and how you can be a... Well, you want to be an imparter, a teacher, baby, but an imparter. Shaun, you're terrific. God bless you, brother.
God bless you, too.
Thank you. Well, we also have a web exclusive with Shaun, and to see that, just go to cbn.com, and you can, it's in the green room link, and you can get more.